everyone, it's me, Cheryl. I hope you are all right. It's a breezy Tuesday morning. Very nice. It was a bit nippy this morning, but it's warmed up a little bit. And I've just got back from the post office, and I decided not to brush my hair because I'm going to be modelling some hats. So, I kept going with those hats, you know. This hat, I decided I wasn't sure whether I liked it because of all the white. It was like double-stranded. It's turned out all right. Look at that pom-pom. I'll talk about pom-poms in a moment. It's okay, but I don't really like it. It's fine. It's a functional hat, nevertheless. Then I made a hat out of the yarn that I actually went and got because I thought, oh, I prefer that solid colours. There you go. I don't even put them on, ever. Yeah. So I was going to model some hats and I didn't put them on, so there's that one. Awesome, yeah. And that one. But before I show you another hat, let me talk about these pom-poms and why they're so different. This one, I made it on this. It's only an imitation, really, is if you were only making one pom-pom. This is really good for lots of pom-poms. So what I did with this, I wrapped it on the shorter side several times, tied it into the middle, and then snipped it there and there. And of course it ends up like this, which is not quite right. Had I been making two of these hats with two of those colour pom-poms, I've got some yarn caught on there, I'd have been able to wrap it, tie it here, snip it there, snip it there, and I'd have had two bushy pom-poms and it would have looked so much better. Never, you know, I could actually, if I really wanted to, start trimming it down a lot more, like my younger son did with the hat he made the pom-pom for CJ. This one, I found a pom-pom maker I forgot I had. They came with some DPNs. I ordered some DPNs earlier on in the year. And it came with a set. Now, where's the packet? Well, there's the packet. And I haven't put them... Oh, yeah, they're down there. I just haven't put them in there. It's because they keep falling out, you see. So there's the biggest one I used. It, basically, it's like the clover. But I know I've got another pom-pom maker somewhere that came free with a magazine, but I was going like this with this, and I couldn't figure out how on earth it was supposed to work. And I just dropped it in a drawer somewhere, and I've no idea where it is. But I'm glad I gave this a second chance. Because even though it looks a bit weak and feeble, I thought it'd be a bit more solid. It actually worked really well, as you can see. There. So I'm really happy with that. I did make Christopher's, CJ's, Santa hat. I'm caught up there. Excuse me a moment. That's it. I did make his Santa hat. And I started on the, it's like falling apart, it should have a little, I think it should have a little clip thing where you can clip it into place and it stays there. I made his Santa hat on the 41 peg loom and I completely changed the yarn because the yarn I was originally using, the white DK with two strands of white glitter yarn, I just abandoned that. Because when I was out last time, I got chunky yarn, white and red. And I also spotted some white eyelash, which I've never used before. So that made the brim. And I still use that, the glitter, doubled with that, for the main part of the hat. This, with the glitter in. I think it might qualify for any yarn with glitter in. It's not very stretchy at all. And I had a hell of a time doing 1/2 on this loom. It was hurting my fingers. I frogged it back to the very last white stitches. Basically what I did, I got my interchangeable knitting needle of the same size, well, roughly the same size, and just picked up all of the white stitches, and then I ran out of cord because it only had 24-inch cord on there at that time. So I started to have to pull them off the loom just a bit so I could get the cord all the way around, picking up the white stitches, putting the back on so the brim was intact, and basically I ended up doing 1/1 because my fingers really hurt. And luckily, I didn't bend the hook, the pick. Then I made a pom-pom with that pom-pom maker I just showed you, the clover-like one. And I made it with the chunky yarn and, big mistake, eyelash yarn. Do not make a pom-pom with eyelash yarn unless you want to snow inside your house, because that's what's just happened. I'm going to have to get the vacuum cleaner out. But anyway, I will show you the Santa hat. It looks really cute. So there it is with the eyelash yarn. There is some elastic in there. But even 1/2 is a bit tight on there, but so much easier than this part. And there's the pom-pom. It looks really fuzzy in there. And I will model that for you. How good's that? Seems a bit twisty there. Maybe it's just what I'm doing. I don't know. Yeah, it doesn't matter. It's unique. That's the main thing. So that's CJ's Santa hat. He's going to be well chuffed with that. Well, actually, I don't think he'll care, but never mind. Everybody else who looks at him will be well chuffed with it. Yeah, so that's turned out really well. This one, before I took it off the loom, I just moved every alternate stitch over. Well, it's an odd number, it's 41. But I did it insofar as I could and basically knit it off, and then it's scrunched up. With this one and this one. What did I do? Yes, first of all I did the first stitch, like I did with that one. And then when I took it off the needles, I reduced it even further. But I took it off with a needle and then knit two together, knit one, knit two together, knit one. Because then I had 21 stitches, you see. When you reduce by half on here, you go from 41 to 21 because it's not exactly divisible. But with 21, you can divide it by 3 then, you see. So I'd knit two together, knit one, knit two together, knit one. But every alternate row was knit. So it looks somewhat like... There is a little bit of a hole, but nowhere near as much as there was before because it all knits together. So that's how I did them, finished them off. So that was good, and now I've gone back to my crochet. Ah! You watch somebody last for a hat. Not while I'm Christmas crocheting. Anyway, this is going to be another road trip scarf. I'm about halfway through that, and it's using... I love that James Seabrook wood blender. Now, I have a question. What does that look like to you? Does that look red? Or does it look brown? Because in the shop it looked red, and here it looks red, but when I'm working on it downstairs, it's looking brown. How strange that is. But I got it thinking, oh, red. Oh, and when I looked at it online, it's L7. If you Google James Seabrook Woodlander and look at number L7, it looks red. Anyway, and here it looks brown. But it might look red as it's draping and stuff like that. But that's working up quite quickly. At least I can get concentrating on that again. I'll just be at the post office and posted off some packages to my friends. Post a few Christmas cards. I need to put some notes in other ones. So I need to really get to it, you know. Oh, and I received a Christmas card from Amy Gibson of Amy's Woolly World of Creations. Thank you so much for that, Amy. It was, I got that last Wednesday, and it was the first, was it Wednesday or Thursday I got it? I'm sure it's Wednesday. I don't want to dwell too much on that. It was either Wednesday or Thursday. I'm sure it's Wednesday. Yeah, it was the first Christmas card we received outside the family, so thank you for that. And yeah, I've gone and left it downstairs on the mantelpiece, so I can't show you all. But yeah, it says the word Santa all over it. It's lovely. Really cute. Thank you for that, Amy. Gosh, I can't believe it's December. Oh, it's not a month I'm really fond of. Oh my goodness, did you hear about the Black Friday sales in the UK? To do with Tesco, people trampling all over each other for TVs, really? Do they not know about Hillsborough? It's just madness. I stayed home, thankfully. Anyway, I think that's everything. Yeah, it is. I've got a couple more packages to sort for my family. I've been to the post office and I could have sent something else, but I haven't even bagged it up or anything like that. Oh, why did I forget that? Oh, my mind was elsewhere. Anyway, that's it. So I'll see you next video. Hope everyone has a good week. Take care, everyone. Bye-bye.